Don't need it anyway. If it leaves my eyes. Y'all talk back to me. This is what leaders do. They practice and burn the midnight oil to have it ready for when they come together with their group. So I'm just practicing. I'm just running it, this choreography over and over again until I can't mess it up. It's rough around the edges, but I'm trying to get it down pat. Amen.
So make sure it looks right.
So I'm practicing with a practice video just for y'all to see. I got the practice video on, following it, because I practice make permanent.
Time to what?
talk back to me. Hey, y'all. Talk back to me. I'm in here practicing by myself. I believe that practice makes permanent. Amen. Somebody type that in the comments, that practice makes permanent. How much time do you spend practicing? Talk back to me. I've literally just done this first 5 minutes of this song 4 times back to back. I'm on 27 minutes, 245 calories burned. So y'all talk to me. How often do you practice when preparing for a ministry assignment? How often do you practice? Oh, praise God, that it's encouraging you, sister. Let me flip the camera around. This is my little water break. So today, let me just tell you guys, today was a very busy day for me. Let me pause my timer because I need to get all my time in. But today was a very busy day for me. Instead of me coming into the studio and practice first like I normally do, I kind of came in here today and I got to work. But in the back of my mind, because I made this goal to myself, that Tuesday through Saturday, I would dance for 1 hour a day to try to get my body back in shape and just be ready for whatever God's going to do or use me to do. You know, it takes discipline and it takes working at it. So, like I said, my day was very busy. And then I have this thing that when my kids get out of school, I want to be home there for them. And so our church is preparing for a funeral tomorrow, so I have to go and help set up some stuff for that. But I went, I saw my kids, went and did that, and then I wanted to spend some more time with them, so we went to a basketball game. Game didn't even start till 8. We got home about 9:30-ish, and so then I was like, you know what? I still have to keep this vow. The vow that I made was to practice 1 hour a day, Tuesday through Saturday. So I got to keep that vow that I made to myself, because I want to be God to be able to flow through me without hindrances or without restraint. And a lot of times we want to get up and minister, but we haven't really studied to show ourselves approved. We haven't put the time in to practice. We haven't put the time in to listen to the music and meditate and worship. We haven't done that. But then we expect that the Spirit of the Lord is going to fall on us. And God is a God of decency and order. He's not going to just fall on you just because. He wants the vessel that has been preparing for for his Spirit to fall. He's just not going to fall on you because you feel like you deserve it or you earned it. He's not going to do that. And so with that being said, you know, practice does not make perfect. I'm totally against that. I believe that practice makes permanent. And there's a t-shirt coming for that real soon. Practice makes permanent. So it's 10:53, my Central Standard Time. And I'm in the studio grinding it out because I believe that practice makes permanent. And I went my whole day working and getting other stuff done, but I can't neglect to take care of the temple. My body is a temple where the Spirit of the Lord dwells. And I actually have a event coming up with a sister who has an event on the 30th. And my body has to be prepared. My body has to be ready to flow in whatever capacity the Holy Spirit wants. And so that means I have to discipline this body. I have to train this body to come under subjection. And I have to train this body to be a vessel that the Holy Spirit can't flow through. The Holy Spirit can't flow through somebody tired and out of shape and overweight. And I look small to some of you, but for my height, you know, I'm carrying about 10 extra pounds. That makes it heavy for me to do the will of the Lord. So I've got to get rid of that because I've got to do the will of the Father. I got to do the will of him that sent me. So if you all are in ministry and you're in dance ministry, I want to encourage you to study to show yourself approved, a workman that need not be ashamed, rightly divided the word of truth. You need training. And that's something that the church doesn't even want to acknowledge nowadays, especially the ministers of dance. They think everything is prophetic, but I'm here to tell you that what you are calling prophetic is really slowfulness. You're too afraid to learn choreography because you've never been trained and you don't think you're going to get it and you don't think you can keep up with it. So you use the term, I flow prophetically as a scapegoat. And when I tell you on Judgment Day, all these prophetic ministers of dance are going to get their face cracked because God's going to hold them accountable for not studying and mastering their craft. You have been given a gift, but it is your job to cultivate it. If the Lord give you seeds to plant to get a harvest, and you don't plant the seed, it can never spring up and bring a harvest. You just got seed. And you can't eat that seed. You can't do nothing with the seed. It's just seeds. But when you put the seed in the ground, it produces something that can nourish you, that can feed you, that can cause an increase, depending on what that seed is. And a lot of times, we as ministers of movement have been given the gift of God. You've been given a gift to dance, but you have fear that you can't keep up with other people. You have fear that you can't learn choreography. You are intimidated because of how other people dance, and you don't think that you dance as well as them. Or you are in competition because you really want to be better than this one and that one. And your pride is stinking, and it's a stench before the Lord. And this is the kind of stuff that we need to talk about as ministers of movement, because this is what is out there. I'm not talking about something that's foreign and far-fetched. This is what is plaguing the ministers of movement in every church. Either a competition spirit or a spirit of pride, because I did a teaching on this. Pride can even mask itself as insecurity, and pride can mask itself as false humility, when really the truth of the matter is you're just too afraid to let somebody teach you. And so I'm going to plug this in right here, and then I need to get back to my practice because I still got 30 minutes more to go. If you guys would like me to minister a specific song, type the song in the comments. I'll pull it up on a music player, and I'll minister it for you tonight. But it's going, whoever types in the song first, that's the song I'm going to pick. Even if I don't know it, that's going to be flowing prophetically. That's not going to be being lazy, because I already been dancing for 28 minutes straight, okay? I'm like drenched in sweat over here. But anyway, I'm saying all to say, I'm going to plug this in. If you go to my website, yetpraisedancecompany.com, I have all kind of classes. There's no reason for you not to train. Everything is 100% online. Some classes have homework, some classes do not. But my point to you is, if you are a minister of movement, you need to be training. I'm 41 years old. I'm 145 pounds. I am 15 pounds heavier than my normal body weight. I'm normally 130, between 125 and 130. And I didn't gain this weight in the pandemic. This has been something that's happened over the last 3 years. And the Lord has been really dealing with my heart and keeping my body, this temple that is his temple, prepared for his use. And your body can't be prepared for the usage of the Lord if you are not training it and bringing it under subjection. You've got to apply the word to yourself. And so that's what I'm doing in here tonight. I've made a vow that I'm going to train 1 hour a day from Tuesday through Saturday. I have a ministry assignment coming up, and I need to be prepared, and I need to be ready for it. And so that's what I'm in here doing. I have 30 more minutes. If you would like for me to minister a song, because a part of what I'm doing to train myself is ministering prophetically to any music. If you have a song that you want me to minister to right now, go ahead and type it in the comments. Whoever types their song in first, it's a song I'm going to minister, and then I'm going to end the video because I got to get back to my own practice. But I want to encourage you, if you are a minister of movement, don't just be getting up there talking about you flowing prophetically when you really are saying, I was too lazy and too nervous and too afraid to go and find a song and choreograph it, because that's really what's happening right now. Travis Green, Living Water. Okay, let me go ahead and put that on. Let me flip the camera back. I'll just turn it over here so you guys can see me. There's a TV. I was practicing with our practice video. Let me pull that up.
Shayla wants Travis Green, Living Water. I never heard this before, so this is going to truly be prophetic. That's what prophetic is. But you got those of you who think you're just going to get up there and come in somebody's church and just minister. Thank God, Shayla. It's only 4 minutes and 3 seconds,
so let's do this. Hallelujah. My mother knows that. Can I get somebody to start interceding for me? Go ahead, start interceding. Because it's going to be by faith. I was down until I got tired and got up.
I'm gonna give you the full song.
I'm a down.
I ain't gonna cheat you, Shayla. What y'all think about that? Oh, I've never even heard this song before. Talk to me in the chat. Shayla, you still here? Because you asked for that. I've never heard that song before in life. Today is the first day I ever heard it. One more song. If you have a song, go ahead, type it in the chat. I'm gonna try one more. one more song. Type the name of the song and the artist while I breathe. Hey, man, any dance leaders on a video? Nikki, what happened? I thought y'all were coming up here for a workshop. What happened? Talk back to me. It's really important that when you minister like that, that you regulate your breathing. So I'm gonna do that for a minute, okay, and stop talking. I'm trying to regulate my heart rate. If you have another song, type the name of the song. Girl, Mary, Mary, get up. I am not a praise dancer. I'm a worship dancer. Sorry, Ariel. Ain't happening. I don't do praise. I do worship. Deliver me. Oh, my gosh. Okay. Nikki, what happened? All right, let me turn this camera. Let me tell y'all something. In the beginning, I hated that song, Nikki. The Deliver Me. I'm not gonna do the full song because it's like 12 minutes. But I'll go for it. Alright. I found a 5-minute version. Pray for me. Y'all praying for me? All right, here we go.
Restore my soul. When you become a believer, your spirit is made right. Sometimes, your soul doesn't get the... He leads me beside still waters. You restore my soul. When you become a believer, your spirit is made right. Sometimes the soul doesn't get the notice. It has a hold in it due to things that's happened in the past, hurt, abuse, molestation. But we want to speak to you today and tell you that God wants to heal the hold in your soul. Some people's actions are not because of their spirit being wrong, but it's because the past has left a hold in their soul. May this wisdom help you get over your past. And remind you that God wants to heal the hole in your soul. I have my sister Leandra here. She's going to help me share this wisdom and tell this story.
Osaya. Hoshia la 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 soka ra la la ha. Heshende de 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 osa. Ho ra la 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 ha ya. Ho. Hande de 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 ohanda. Let me tell you something. If you don't have a cry, if you don't have a cry, handa la 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 so. If you don't have a cry deep down in your spirit for the Lord to deliver you, let me tell you something. The Bible said that all, me, you, and everybody else, all of us have sinned to come short of the glory of God. Ain't none righteous but Jesus. We take the righteousness of Christ because of what he's already done. Ain't none of us holier than thou. Ain't none of us all that. Oh, but if right now, I got 14 people on this video, and I know beyond a shadow of a doubt that right now, all 14 of you are not living a born again lifestyle. What is that, Sister Rachel? What is born again? Born again means that you are hungry and thirsty for righteousness. You are reading your Bible daily and doing what it say. You are praying constantly and fervently, and you are doing what it say, what he says to do in prayer. I'm not talking about going to church, because going to church don't save you. I could go in a garage and that don't make me a car. So going into the church house don't make you a Christian. How do you respond under pressure? Are you still going to the club? Are you still drinking and smoking and cussing people out when you get mad? If you're doing those things, I love you, but you are not a Christian. Because the Bible said that the action, if you go look up the definition of Christian, it means Christ-like. It means imitator of Jesus Christ. Jesus wasn't drinking and clubbing and cussing. I can't stand to see those shirts on Facebook where it say, I'm a Christian, but I cuss a little bit. You a devil. Don't you wear that shirt. You a devil. The Bible said in Revelation 3:16 that I'd rather you be hot or cold, because if you are lukewarm, I'm going to vomit you out of my mouth. That tells me it's black or white with Jesus. There is no shades of gray. If you dance for the church and you dance for the world and shake it and drop it like it's hot, you're not a Christian. Don't deceive yourself. If I didn't love you and if I didn't care about you, I wouldn't tell you this. But I don't want to see you die and go to a devil's hell and you say, didn't nobody warn me of what was coming my way if I didn't surrender to Jesus Christ. So if you're on this video, and I know you're here because the Holy Ghost wouldn't have me doing this if you were not here. And I can actually call a few names out because the Holy Spirit is telling me right now who it is. But some of you on this video need to come right now and repent. Because let me tell you something. Jesus is coming back for a church, that's you and I, not a building, without a spot, a wrinkle, or a blemish. We can't be that perfect in ourselves. We need the righteousness of Christ. We need the sacrifice that Jesus made to help us to live right. Don't click off this video right now because I'm trying to get your soul saved. I don't care how good you dance. I don't care how much money you got. I don't care how many businesses and what your reputation is. Is your name found in the Lamb's Book of Life? The Bible says in the book of Revelation, he says that he's going to open a book to judge and to look. And whoever's name is not written in that book of life, they're going to be sentenced to a devil's hell. That hell is eternal separation from God. How long is eternity? Somebody tell me. Eternity never ends. There is no end in eternity. There's no end in a circle. It just keep going. And so the Bible said that to add to your torment, there's going to be a great gulf fixed. So while you're down in hell, burning with the flame that never die and the worm that don't cease to come and crawl through your body, because all your flesh going to burn off. He going to put it back on you again, and it's going to burn off over and over again for eternity. I hope I'm scaring the hell out of somebody, because you got to come on and get free for real today. Somebody on this video, you've been straddling the fence. You've been playing games with God, and God say, enough is enough. I want all of you today. Some of y'all are going to have to shut down businesses and change lifestyles, because God does not want you doing both. He wants you doing one. There's one way. Straight and narrow is the path that leads to eternal life. He said, there are few there be that shall find it. I'm giving you Bible. I'm not giving you Sister Rachel opinion. I'm giving you what thus saith the Lord. But the Bible said it's going to be a great gulf fixed, so that all the people that are burning and being tormented in hell going to be able to look up through the great gulf fixed and see all the souls in heaven rejoicing and worshiping and praising and having everything that God promised them. And they're going to be in torment and can't have it. The rich man died, and immediately he opened his eyes in a place of torment. And he said, Lord, he said, let me go back and tell my family to live right so they don't have to come here. And the Lord said, no, they got prophets. They got pastors and teachers. Let them tell them. You can't come out of this place. And he said, but Lord, if somebody came from here to tell them, they will repent and believe. No, they not. How many people done died and came back and said that what they saw in the church still don't believe? Why is it that I had more viewers before the altar call while I had music on dancing? But when I start talking about giving your life to Christ, the viewers drop. Because the truth of the matter is that the Christians don't really want a born again lifestyle. They want to go to church. They want the spirit of religion, but they don't want to forgive and turn the other cheek. They don't want to love the unlovable. They don't want to sacrifice and give up the club and the worldly and the secular music. They don't want that. And I'm not putting you down. I'm saying that's our flesh. Our flesh desires that sin is pleasurable for a season. I enjoyed working in a strip club. I didn't do it because I had to. I did it because I loved it, because I didn't know no better. It wasn't until Jesus Christ changed my life. I tell y'all this all the time. I got saved on a stage in a strip club. I heard the audible voice of the Lord speak to me and say, I don't want you here. I have something better for you. And I'm on the stage half naked. I wasn't drunk nor high. I said, well, Lord, I'm gonna make this deal with you. You help me to pay enough money, make enough money to pay all my bills, and I'll never come back here again. That night in the club, I made $742, which was enough to pay all my bills and catch a taxi cab home, and I never went back again. I gave my life to the Lord Jesus Christ. I was 19 years old. I am 41 right now. I have never one day backslid and turned against the things of God. The Lord has kept me for almost 22 years. Somebody give God the glory right there. Somebody, you could give God the glory right there. They should have hearts blowing up this page. This video should be being shared and all of that, because I'm talking right now about what can save your soul for eternity. What can save your soul for eternity? My God. So if you are on this video and you have not made Jesus the real Lord, I'm not talking about the go to church Lord. I'm talking about the real Lord, where you eat the Bible, you sleep the Bible, you live the Bible, you talk the Bible. Everybody know you a walking Bible. They blow up your messenger with prayer requests because they know you pray and you seek the face of the Lord. People come to you instead of going running around all the rest of them because they know you a real one. Come on, somebody. If you are not where you need to be with Jesus, all I want to do is pray with you. You might have had some life circumstances and situations to happen that kind of threw you off a little bit. All I want you to type in a comment is, that's me. And I'm going to pray with you before I get off this video. I'm not praying no sinner's prayer. I'm going to pray for God to come into your heart and restore you. Because sometimes life happens and we fall and miss the mark. Ain't nobody perfect. I told y'all that. We all sinners saved by grace. The problem is you can't be a habit sinner. You can't be sleeping with that man all the time and you're not married to him. You can't be sleeping with him no time if you're not married. You got to have a covenant to get in the bed. Amen? You got to have covenant. Oh, come on here, somebody. If you on this video, before I get off, I just finished ministering, deliver me. If you want to be delivered right now, type deliver me in the chat. Come on, because we can't keep doing this. You can't be saved this week and falling off the wagon next week. And I'm not bashing you or putting nobody down. This is real love. The Bible said that real love is correction. And see, we got it all twisted. We want real love to be, well, you make me feel good and you say nice things to me. But real love is saying, baby, that's a bad, dangerous road that's going to lead to destruction. Don't go that way. That's real love. Real love say, baby, get out the way. They got an 18-wheeler coming. That's real love. Come on, somebody type real love. If you want to pray and be restored back to where you need to be in God, all I want to do is pray with you tonight before I get off this video. I'm not on this video for likes. I ain't on this video for shares. I'm on this video for souls right now. I'm on this video for souls. And if you say, you know what, I'm just not where I need to be. I'm not where I need to be, but I want to be restored. Type it in the comments. Hit that chat. Hit that chat. I'm going to get some water for a minute. But if that's you, I want to lead you into a prayer. I'm going to pray for you. You don't, and I want to pray for the Lord to restore you. And there's no shame in this. All of us had to repent. All of us had to ask the Lord Jesus to forgive us at some point in our life. If you ain't never asked for forgiveness, you might not be saved. So I'm going to give a couple more minutes. If that's you, just type, "That's me." And I know you're on the video because the Lord don't have me to do this for no reason. But the blood not going to be on my hands because I offered it. Now you could go ahead and say, "I'm going to go and pray on my own." I pray God honor that. Do what you got to do to get it right. Do what you got to do. But if you look at the signs of the time, this is not the time to be playing games with God. I'm telling you, oh Lord Jesus, there is a worse thing coming. Y'all thought COVID shook the world. But what God is going to release next, there ain't going to be enough stimulus, ain't going to be enough toilet paper, ain't going to be enough food to fix what's coming next. So you better be right with the Lord Jesus, because only the righteous going to be spared in this one. I believe the Spirit of the Lord said the righteous are going to be spared in this next thing that's coming. But it's coming. It's coming. And you better be ready. It's coming. It's coming whether you're ready or not. Your best bet is to get yourself ready. I see you. I see you, Ariel. I'm going to pray for you. Is there anybody else? So I can pray with my sister. I see you, Asia. I see you, Hashina. I'm going to pray with you all. And there's no shame. There's no shame. Let me tell y'all something. The Lord be dealing with me. Man, he be dealing with me. I swear, I feel like I be repenting all day long sometimes because the Lord is constantly showing me my ugly ways that's not like him. I'm telling you, I be done thought something or felt a certain kind of way or been like somebody get on my nerves and I can't stand them. And the Lord be like, "Who are you? Who do you think you are? You just done, you done got on the throne. You greater than my son." Can I be real? Man. Let me go ahead and pray. I want to pray for those ladies that said that's me. I just want to offer up a word of prayer because God honors prayer. The most violent thing that you can do is pray. The devil is terrified of the weakest intercessor because the weakest intercessor has more power than him. The weakest, the puniest, the intercessor that can't say nothing but "help me, Lord," has more power than the devil has. Because whenever you cry out to the Lord, the Bible says when the righteous cry out, the Lord stops what he's doing and he listens and hears and give attention. And he said that the prayer of the righteous man avail much. That means that prayer is going to get answered. Oh God, who am I talking to? Come on, can somebody say, "Lord, I want a stronger prayer life. I want a stronger prayer life." You hit the chat and say that because it's out of the confession of your own mouth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, I pray for my sisters tonight. Lord, each of them are dealing with something completely different from the other one. But Lord, I'm asking right now for a spirit of restoration to consume them, that they will rededicate their life to you, that they will give you all their heart, they will give you all their mind, they will give you all their soul, they will give you all their strength. Lord, I'm praying that you would put a heavy conviction in their heart to read your word daily and to memorize scriptures. I pray that you would put a heavy conviction on their heart to pray without ceasing, to literally have the attitude and spirit of prayer. I pray that they would thrive on intimate fellowship with you, that they would just find themselves wanting to be with you and wanting to be in your presence. Lord, I pray that you remove every person that is trying to connect with them, that is trying to kill or desensitize their anointing, anybody that's trying to suck the spiritual life out of them. Oh God, I feel like there's some leeches in the spirit that's trying to latch hold to some of them and suck and drain the life out of them. If that's you, I want you to message me. If you're having somebody that you feel like is attaching to you to almost drain you spiritually, I need you to private message me. But Father, I pray, Lord, for my sisters right now in the name of Jesus. You say who the Son sets free is truly free indeed. So I pray for supernatural freedom to consume and overtake them right now in the mighty name of Jesus. I hear the Spirit of the Lord say that no weapon formed against you shall be able to prosper. Oh, Father, I thank you right now that it's forming, but it's not prospering. I thank you that your hand, the hand of the Lord is blocking something right now. One of you ladies that said that's me, I feel like the Spirit of the Lord is blocking something. It's actually something that you're trying to do, but God doesn't really want you to do it right now. And the Spirit of the Lord is actually being that block. The Spirit of the Lord is blocking that thing, and He's keeping it from coming to pass. And if you continue to fight, you're going to be fighting God. And it's not that God doesn't want you to have it. It's just that you're premature. It's not time yet. It's not time yet. And so I feel like the Spirit of the Lord is doing this. Like, it's the Spirit of the Lord is blocking you. And He's, because He doesn't want you to go into it yet. You got the right idea. You got the right vision, but it's not the right time. You're not ready for it. And if you continue to go forth and make it happen, you're gonna fight God, and it's not gonna be good. So take this as a word of encouragement. Just go ahead and back in Jesus' name. Thank you for that word, Lord God. Thank you for that word, Lord. There's somebody on the video that's been dealing with some, and I don't want you to acknowledge who you are. I do want you to private message me. There's somebody that's dealing with some loneliness and some depression, and even this week you've dealt with suicidal thoughts. The Lord says, I know you. I know right where you are. He says He knows right where you are, and He's strengthening you. He is who has strengthened you throughout this week to keep going and not give up. The Lord has been strengthening you. You haven't felt it. You didn't even feel that it was the strength of the Lord. You don't even know how you made it through this week. But the Lord told me to tell you He was strengthening you. He was strengthening you to get through. If that's you, I need you to private message me. And I don't want you to, because of the nature of that prophecy, I don't want you to acknowledge yourself out in the open. You know, that's a sensitive situation. If you want to, you can private message me, just so we can further dialogue and pray. Oh, Father, I feel the Spirit of the Lord in this place. You see, when you walk in the presence of the Lord, you don't need no music. You don't need the hype. You don't need the hollering. You don't need that when you walk with Jesus. When you walk with the Holy Spirit, you don't need all. I'm not saying those things are bad. I love music. I love shouting and bucking and jumping, but it got to have some purpose behind it. But what I'm saying is the Spirit of the Lord can move anywhere, in any kind of way, in any fashion, any form. You just got to be available. You just got to be willing. Hallelujah. Can somebody type willing in the chat? Willing in the chat. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Is Raquel Rocky Salters still on the video? If you're on the video, say, I'm here. Oh, la la ba so kana na na ma sha na na ma so te de 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 bo sanda. Oh, sa na 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 ma shi ni 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 bo so to ro 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 bo sanda. Oh, da 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 da. Nikki, I need you to private message me after this video. I may not answer y'all messages tonight because it's late and I have an early funeral in the morning, but Nikki, I need you to private message me after this video. Oh, la 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 ba so ta na 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 ma shi ni ni mo so to do 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 bo sa ta. I ka da da ba so la 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 ba san da 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 ba sa ta. Oh, thank you, God. I hear the Lord say, by the confession out of your own mouth, by the confession, with all of y'all that's typing willing, you don't even understand what you're decreeing in the spirit. The Lord is searching. In the book of Isaiah, He said that the Lord was searching, saying, who will go for me? And there was nobody to go. And then Isaiah decided to say, Lord, I'll go. He was willing. And I see all of y'all putting willing in the comments, willing, willing. And all I hear is that's what God needs. He needs a willing vessel. He needs somebody that's willing that He can flow through. God wants to flow through His people. But the problem is we're too busy and preoccupied doing us. We're too busy, preoccupied doing us, that we don't have room for God to come in and intervene. Oh, my Shaya. Tanisha, you got to go back and watch the whole video, boo. Hatarabako shana na masaya. Oh, la 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 ba so te de 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 ashanda do do bo sanda. I don't know who this is for, but I hear that you are. I don't know if it's for the same person before, but I hear it in the spirit that you are premature. You're gonna give premature birth if you move right now. You're gonna have a premature baby that's not gonna be able to live if you move right now. This preemie is so premature that once you deliver it, It's not going to live because it's too premature. I don't know who this is for. It's not time to deliver yet. It is not time. Oh, God. It's not time. It's not time to deliver. You know, at some stages of pregnancy, if you deliver that baby too soon, the baby is not developed enough to live. And I don't know if this goes back with the prophecy from earlier with the person that God is saying, stop, don't go any further. But somebody is trying to have a baby and deliver and birth out what God wants them to do, but it's not time yet. It is not time yet. You are so premature. And let me tell you something. I know about being premature. You'll kill the whole vision, or you're going to go through pure hell and have warfare that you're not ready for. My God, thank you for that word, Lord. Somebody say, thank you, God. I won't be premature. I will not be premature. So if that's you, I need you to message me. If you're trying to act on something and you're trying to put some wheels on something right now and you believe God is telling you you're premature, I need you to private message me. And I've been doing a private message thing because some of these things are very sensitive and I don't want to be like I'm blasting people because that's never the intent, to blast or hurt anybody. But sometimes you have to hit the brakes in the spirit. We get a vision or idea from God and we take off and we run with it. But you've got to be ready for the warfare that comes with that. My God, who am I talking to? If you haven't already, I want you to go to my website. And if you can't find a resource or you don't have money for a resource and you see something on the website that you need or you believe God wants you to have, message me. I'm going to give it to you for free tonight, okay? If there's a resource on my website that you believe that you need to have this resource, but you don't have the finances for it, I'm going to give it to you for free. Private message me. If you've never been to my website, go to yetpraisedancecompany.com and just subscribe and become a site member. That way you can always keep up with what we're doing. I put out a blog today, and the blog is about prayer, and it's about crying out on behalf of what we see going on right now in this world. The devil has set the church up to be so divided. The world is divided, but the church is divided. Because you got half of the church for President Trump, you got half of the church for President Biden, President-elect Biden. And so the half of the church is calling one half false prophets and the other half think they're more high and righteous than the ones that did the prophecies and all of this. And all of it was a plot to get the church divided because we can't stand a kingdom divided against itself is going to destroy itself. And so we are so divided that it's not even funny. I'm at this point, I'm not for either president. I'm for holiness and righteousness. I'm going to cover in prayer both men because the Bible says you're supposed to pray for those that are in authority. But if you look at what's going on in the world right now, we need the church to be lifting up a standard and to be a beacon light to help those that are hurting. The church can't be compromised and lukewarm and expect to help those that are struggling in sin. My God. But anyway, I want you to go to my website, yetpraisedancecompany.com. If you're not a website subscriber, just go and subscribe. If you can't afford something on the website, buy it. Because those things, for those of you who don't know, I've gone full-time into the ministry as of August of 2020. So literally, I do full-time dance ministry, 7 days a week. I offer counseling services where I sit down and counsel ministers of dance from all over the world. We've got people in all countries. I have online schools we teach. I've got constant programs that we're teaching and recording. Sometime tomorrow I have to get in here and record another class. I mean, literally I've given my life for this. Sometimes I'm in this building 12 hours a day. Let me show y'all so y'all understand how serious this is to me. We got stage props set up here. This is where we record videos. There's another backdrop on the ground right there getting ready to be ironed and pressed out to be put up here. This is another backdrop where we record. I'm not just Sister Rachel talk about it. I'm literally, I get up. The first thing I do when I come in here is I come into prayer and I'm seeking the face of God. You know what I'm saying? And what I'm trying to do, I need people to partner with me to help me to push the gospel of Jesus Christ. We preach to regular people, but the call is to the ministers of movement so that we can teach them to live a holy and a righteous lifestyle. And there's people in other countries that just don't have the money for our program. We give so many resources away. Just like I told y'all tonight, anybody that need resources and you don't have the money, go ahead and message me. I'm going to give it to you because it's always ministry first. But even if you are not a minister of movement and you want to go ahead and sow a seed into the ministry, you can do it through the Cash App, which is $YPDC. YPDC. Keandra, if you on the video, put the, or somebody put that in the comments for me. $YPDC. You can sow a seed through our Cash App, or you guys can go to the website, yetpraisedancecompany.com. Click the tab that says online giving, and there's two ways you can give. You can give a one-time donation through PayPal, or you could become a monthly partner. We got monthly partnerships as low as $5 a month. And all, thank you, Hashina, and all that money goes to help people that can't afford, because we give so much away. Because I think that's why our ministry thrives and our ministry survives, because we give so much away, y'all. I mean, when I tell you, some months I don't be knowing how we gonna make it because we didn't probably gave away too much that month. But I'm telling all you all this because I do this full time. I don't have a 9-to-5. I don't get a paycheck. I walked off my job and everything to do this full time for the Lord. So I need monthly partners. We not a mega ministry, and I'm not trying to have my face plastered on a poster. I'm trying to have my name written in the Lamb's Book of Life because I did God's will. But your money, when you sow your seed, it goes into this ministry to keep the doors open. We just ordered new equipment. I got equipment in boxes on my desk because we got to get better equipment for the audio to make the sound more crisp and clear. Because where my building is located is right off the highway. So when big trucks and stuff are passing, you can hear it. So I have to get a new audio system to plug into the video. And all this stuff costs money, and we just pay for it out of our pocket because this is what we believe. My husband and I believe this is what God's will is for my life in this season. But if you can, hit the Cash App and bless us. Go to the website. Just sign up and become a site member. Go give online through the website. Even if you just become a $5 a month member, all of those $5 add up to help us to keep going. You know, it's very expensive. I don't know if y'all have ever seen the full building, but let me show it to you again. This building that we have, this is almost a 2,000 square foot building. And we've been having this building now for 6 years. But this building and everything in this building, you have to pay for it. Amen. It ain't free. So I want you guys to just consider becoming a partner. I'm not going to drag this video on any longer. Hit the Cash App. Go subscribe to the website. I just put a new blog post up. So go and read the blog. If you will, please share the blog on social media. Text it to people. Encourage others with it because we need to be praying right now. And the blog is specifically about prayer. For the month of January, I'm focusing on purpose, okay? Finding your purpose. What is, why did God born you into the earth? What were you created for? You weren't created just to exist. You have a purpose, and there's people that you have been called to minister to that I'll never meet them, I'll never reach them, but you will. Even if it's just your next door neighbor, God count that as a purpose, amen? So I love you all. Go to yetpraisedancecompany.com and become a site member. That way you'll get emails, you'll be able to keep up with us, you'll know when we're doing stuff, new blogs, new material is out. And if not, just go and sow a seed. And more than anything, pray for our ministry. Pray for Yet Praise Dance Company. Pray for me to be able to do the will of God. This is a new season, and I'm literally walking by faith to do what the Lord has called me to do. I love y'all. Thank you so much for being on the video tonight. If you're just joining in, I'm sorry. I'm checking out right now because I've been on here for a minute. Thank you so much, Monique. Thank you, Myra. I appreciate you guys hanging in here with me tonight. If you need any prayer, you can hit me up in Messenger. If you see a service on my website that you really believe that God is calling you to, but you just cannot afford it, go ahead and send me a message telling me what it is you need. But if you can afford it, bless our ministry by buying it, okay? We got choreography on sale for $98. We got $20 dance classes. There's a dance class in the store of our website where you buy one, you get two free. And I think it's like $25, you get three classes. One class is $20, so you're really getting a bargain, amen? So there's a lot of resources on there. If you're not a dancer, just go sow a seed and help us to keep doing what God's called us to do. I love you guys so much, and I appreciate all of your support and patronage and how you guys are always there. Like and share this video, because your one share, somebody might click on this video and have the resources to fund our ministry. Somebody might click on the video and see the dance and it bless them, or it be the right word for them. Somebody might click on the video and get to the part where we talked about repentance and give their life to Jesus Christ. So there's power in a share. Amen. I love you guys. Have a good night.